you know. So we're going to call the famous, very famous Lane McCray. So he was famous for the Europop dance group La Bouche. And we're going to play just a little recap of his video so you guys can, you know, become, you know, so you can remember what he sings. I know it's been since 1995, so you guys might have forgotten, but you guys are going to hear some fantastic dance music. So here we go.
Yes, I wanna be your lover. Take a chance, my lover's like no other. On the dance floor, getting down. Hold tight, I never let you down. My love, definitely the key. Like poison, man, I'm on bended knee. Loving you, not like your brother. Oh yeah, wanna be your lover.
I hear what you say.
Hello, Lane, how are you doing?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm fantastic. Just so everyone knows who's watching, we have Lane McCray on the line. He's famous for the Europop dance group La Bouche. So we have just a few questions for you today, Lane.
Okay.
The first question I wanted to ask is, so having worked as a duo group to now be out on your own and working on a solo project, are you working on a solo project?
I am. It's been one of those kind of labors of love. And short, you know, after Melanie passed, I took a couple of years off, you know, just trying to contemplate life and, you know, what's the purpose and the meaning of it. And so I've been recording, been writing for some other folks, and actually still touring as La Bouche with Dana Rain. And, you know, it's been a blessing to still be working, you know, after all these years still, you know, as La Bouche, because there's still a huge audience out there.
Oh, yeah. We think you're fabulous here.
Well, thank you.
We love you. So, if you were going to do anything other than singing, what would you want to do? Like, what would be your inspiration?
Probably die. music is everything to me. There's not a day that goes by that I don't actually sit down and write something, whether it's just a line or if it's a hook or something. But, you know, on the practical side of things, if I was doing anything else, my favorite things are to be around my friends, eat, cook, you know. So I've been kind of dabbling in the restaurant business for the last 4 or 5 years, trying to decide if I might possibly want to do that. Other than that, you know, I'm just pretty benevolent. You know, just always want to do something that's going to help people enjoy their lives, take their lives out of the normal day to day, you know, just for some escape. And I find music does that, you know, so that's my first love. And then food is the second love.
Yeah. So you like to cook?
Love it. Oh, it's relaxing. Awesome. I get all my friends together. I get to visit with them. And it's an opportunity for family to come together and fatten them up a little bit, you know.
That's a good time, yeah. So maybe you could even open up your own restaurant and maybe have some acts like come in and sing in your restaurant. I think that would be fun.
That would be fabulous, as you said. I think I've already got a working title for the restaurant. It's called Dinner with Lane.
That would be fun.
Yeah, and music definitely would be a part of that, you know. But trying to decide on what kind of music, you know, because my music taste is so varied from, you know, jazz to obviously, you know, dance music, deep house, progressive. I mean, it's just all over the place, man. But I just love it.
Would you consider your music to be more dance pop?
Yeah, definitely dance pop. It's funny because when I first went to Europe, you know, in the Air Force, I was kind of taken aback, you know, at the music scene over there because, you know, here in the States, our BPMs per considered a dance record were kind of slow. But over there, you know, it was really fast. And when I started hearing people like Martha Wash, Crystal Waters, CeCe Peniston singing on these like dance pop tracks, I was like, okay. And, you know, when I met Melanie and we started doing it, I was like, okay, I'm digging it.
So I noticed your name, La Bouche, it actually is French for the mouth. So I was curious who thought of that name. Was it you or was it Melanie?
It was kind of a combination of a few things. One, you know, my music producer was Frank Farian from the infamous Milli Vanilli scandal. And Melanie and I were both, at least I think I was in my early 30s when this first started. Melanie was in her late 20s, pretty well set in what we wanted and how we wanted it. So we ended up being kind of, not difficult, but, you know, pretty much, you know, saying we didn't want to do this or no, we're not going to do that. And Frank was like, wow, you guys have a lot of mouth. You know, why don't we just call the group The Mouth? We were like, that would be no. What about La Bouche? That's French for the mouth. What was that? Okay. So that's honestly how it derived of our opinionated, you know, observations on a lot of things that went on with us in the early part of our career.
I think it's a fantastic name. I love the name La Bouche. It sounds so fun and so lively. So you have had a successful career behind the scenes. So what made you decide to step out into the limelight?
Well, you know, I'm really honestly, and people laugh at me when I tell them this, but I'm a shy individual. When I get in my environment of like being on stage, or behind the skillet, I'm comfortable with that. So, but if I was to go out by myself, like into a club or into a restaurant, I'd probably walk into a chair or trip over a table or something. But I think, you know, the limelight is not anything that I sought out. It just kind of came. And I'm reminded of this thing that Oprah used to say about success, you know, when preparation meets opportunity. And, you know, I had been working in the confines of the Air Force with an Air Force entertainment group called Tops and Blue that kind of got me ready for that. And I think that's one of the reasons why La Bouche was successful because, you know, Melanie had been out there in the trenches singing any and everywhere, and I was out touring with this Air Force group. So we weren't just kind of plucked out of obscurity, you know, and thrown behind a microphone and then now perform, you know, like a lot of artists, especially in dance music, are. So it's, I mean, the limelight is great, you know, but, you know, the reality is that it's not real. So I think if you look at this like a business that it is, you'll be successful. But if you go into it looking for, you know, fame and fortune and, you know, paparazzi and all that stuff, you know, it's fading. You know, my desire, my dream, and Melly's was just to always be continued working, you know, in the business. Didn't necessarily have to have a hit record out, didn't necessarily have to be on MTV, but just be working, you know, and to be able to provide for our families and make a living and yada, yada, yada.
Yeah, you don't strike me as a very shy person, so I'm kind of shocked right now.
Acting right now, no.
So I think you're a very, very open individual, kind of like an open book. That's what I got. But I think you're an amazing individual. So what kind of pressure do you feel given your history of international chart-topping dance records and like? How does that feel? How does that influence your current project right now?
Pressure. I'll tell you what, the only real pressure that I've actually experienced had been after Melanie passed away. And we were represented at the time by, I'll not mention the name of the agency, but after I took a couple of years off and was ready to go back to work, the young man told me that La Bouche was dead when Melanie died. And so the pressure then became for me to know that I could exist musically without Melanie, you know, God rest her soul. Because not just being the rapper in the group, you know, I'm a pretty well accomplished vocalist, you know, first. And so I felt a little pressure to try to get out there. And I just said, you know what, just, man, just chill out, relax, you know, everything happens for a reason when it's supposed to. And so that's pretty much what I did. And that's what I do now. I still get nervous before I go on stage. So that's a little bit of pressure. But once I'm out there, you know, all bets are off. Shirts are off, whatever, you know. So,
yeah. You and Melanie, I read an interview and you guys were so close. At one point, you almost considered you and Melanie to be married, I read.
Not literally, but metaphorically, you know, yeah, because we spend so much time together. Yeah. We knew, you know, every little nuance of each other. I knew she was not a morning person, so I knew I didn't get up and, you know, because I'm a morning person. Hey, how you doing? What's up? What's going on? You know, and she's like, no, not this morning. You know, tone it down. And she knew, you know, we just had a really nice, you know, balance between us. And when you do spend that much time together, yeah, you get on each other's nerves, you know, but in a good way, always respected each other. I was really in awe of Melanie and just in awe of her voice. Her voice was just incredible, you know, yes. And you don't get kinds of voices every day. And if she had still been here, I just, you know, I just always wonder, you know, of the possibilities of what she could have done, you know.
Oh, yeah. Like, her voice was very empowering, and you were the perfect guy to sing with her.
And yeah, I used to joke around with us all the time. I said, I'm the pretty one. You're the voice. And I'm the
I love it. That's fantastic. Because you are very pretty. You're very pretty.
Oh, whatever.
So who were some of your influence when you were growing up? Like, who were some of your influences?
Justin Bieber.
Did you just say Justin Bieber?
No, I'm an old goat. So I go back to my high school days. Of course, you know, the Jackson 5, Commodores. And it was like one of my early 20s when I got in the Air Force and I was assigned to McGuire Air Force Base in New Jersey. And I was introduced to house music, like the Peach Boys, White Horse, Sharon Page, you know, that kind of house music. I was like, wow, I loved it. Gino Socio. So those were some of my early influences. I mean, I love a nasty bass line. I love house keyboards, anything uplifting.
I hear you're playing some music right now. Is that you? I can hear some music. I love it.
No, this is my defective records collection.
it sounds fantastic.
Yeah. That's what I actually would like to do. I mean, I love dance pop music. I mean, it's done a lot for me. But if I was to say I'm just going to, you know, wither away into obscurity and sing what I want to, it would be this kind of house.
That's good. So who influences your current style? I know you said that the Beach Boys in current year, they influence your previous style.
Yeah.
So who influences you nowadays?
You know, besides listening to this kind of music that it kind of just inspires me generally just to get up and clean my house or just, you know, when I'm driving, I listen to, I really don't listen to the radio. So I don't really, I mean, I hear stuff, you know, admire a lot of artists, you know, but I write from a personal experience. And it's really a marriage between, you know, my producers and myself on what that sound is. I don't want to like limit it or categorize it, but it's a little taste like dance, house, neo soul. And you know, my vocal capabilities are not like, anything I think that's out there because it's pretty different, you know. You know, I'm not from the hood, you know, I'm not trying to perpetrate being that. It's just straight ahead, just music about love, life, wanting to be in love, get out of love, you know, kill somebody, die, you know, I mean, just all the range of emotions that love presents to us.
I know your music really inspires me to get up for the day. Like, if I go on my phone, I have one of those really big smartphones, and sometimes I'll search for La Bouche, Be okay. My Lover, and it just really makes me dance in the shower. It just, like, makes me dance.
Right, well, you have to make sure you have that rubber mat down so you don't bust it.
yeah, definitely. Yeah, but it's a lot of fun. I love your music, and I'm really excited to hear any upcoming projects that you have going on. And I added you on Facebook, so I will be stalking you now.
Stalk on. Well, we do have, you know, some things that are coming up. We've got some dates coming up. We're playing at Roscoe's Tavern in Chicago on the 1st of March. We're doing the World Resort Casino in Jamaica, New York, with Queens. Where Dana and I are back in the studio working on some tracks. You know, we've released some individual tracks over the last year with Dirty Leg Productions. So all that stuff is available on YouTube. Pump It. Dana did a cover called
Dana Rain. Yeah.
Dana Rain. Yeah. And if I could tell you a real quick story too about working with her.
Oh, I'd love to hear it.
When I started going back to work, I was trying to find the right partner. So I kissed a couple of frogs, you know, a couple of girls that'll remain nameless. One was really great, but didn't like work on stage because La Bouche has always been known for just leaving it out there. Another girl, you know, was kind of like, and who actually had tried to use the name to work in Canada. I had to stop that. But she kind of liked to hit the sauce a little bit. And so, you know, we're all about representing our product live. You know, we don't lip sync. We don't, you know, sing on top of the tracks. It's all live. So you've got to be healthy, strong, ready to go. So she didn't work out. Then I had another girl that was a little matronly. And then my manager, Ruben Martinez, who represents Dana, suggested her, you know, as a white girl. You know, I was like, okay, let's try it out, you know. So we were down in Florida. I think the place was the Parliament House in Orlando, I think. And she just came down there and blew me away. I mean, vocal range, stage presence, you know.
I've seen some of her YouTube videos. She sounds really, really incredible. And I believe she has a few singles out from what I've seen.
Yeah. I think the latest one was called Overload.
Oh, okay. Yeah, she's really good. So if anyone would want to check her out, like, it's Dana Rain, DanaRayne. That's his new partner. And she's been with him since 2009. So I also read that you like to help out a lot of AIDS victims, which was very inspiring to me. I think that's absolutely amazing that you do that.
Well, you know, I've never looked for any accolades, you know, for that. I just think, you know, as a human being, that's our job is to show some compassion because, you know, who knows what tomorrow brings for any of us. And when I got involved with the Big Spender affiliation over in Germany, it pretty much was just sitting with people who were literally dying, you know, from AIDS, and talking about it. You know, I discuss a lot of it now with, you know, the kids here in the community that I live, church functions, because people still think that it's, you know, it's not going to affect them, you know, and it's real, you know, and you know, I've had a couple of friends that have died most recently, a couple of weeks ago.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah. Ken Barnett, I'll say his name. He was a good guy, lived in Dallas. And, you know, just unfortunately, you know, just was just too much, you know, and now he's gone, you know. So we can either choose life or we can choose death, you know. And by choosing life, that doesn't mean that you can't participate in life, you know, you just have to be smart about it, you know.
Definitely. I read something that you really believe in karma. Are you like a strong believer in karma?
Yes, I believe everything that you put out there in the universe has a way of coming back to you. I don't treat people nicely because I'm worried about the karma, but I treat people nicely because that's the way I want to be treated. But I believe everything that you do in the dark of night will eventually see the light of day. And I think if you are a mean-spirited person, you know, the universe is gonna slap you in the, it's gonna slap you down.
Definitely, I agree 100%. I think karma is a very good way for, it's like for some people who don't even believe in karma, it's almost nice to like make them believe in it just so they're nice to people. Like, you know, yeah. There's rude people that are just like always rude to people. You just want to be like, karma is going to get you.
And, you know, people always ask me, you know, how I stay calm, you know, because I've had some situations, you know, musically where, you know, we were performing in a place and, you know, the folks didn't have our money. And, you know, any artist knows no money, no show. And they tried to escort us to the stage by gunpoint, you know, from the hotel. And
oh my goodness.
Yeah, I'm like, you know, people don't believe this stuff, you know, but it's like we're in Istanbul, you know, and these big thugs were out at the door. Me, my manager, and Melanie, we were in the room with the chair up against the doorknob, you know, wow. trying to call the embassy. It was real.
Interesting to hear about that.
Yeah, and so, you know, I don't let things upset me. You know, people always ask me, you know, how I stay so young. I said, you know, man, it's just like stress. You know, I don't invite that kind of energy into my life. I don't get excited, you know, because, you know, life has a way of straightening things out that aren't correct. So
that's such a great motto. And you look so young as well. Like, you look amazing. You look fantastic.
Well, I can't lie about my age because you guys probably already know that.
I do, but I will not say anything.
Thank you. Love you.
I'm keeping it a secret. They can Wikipedia you.
Oh, yeah. If they want to help me celebrate the next one, they can come to the World Casino Resort in Jamaica, Queens, and help me celebrate because it's going to be on.
That sounds amazing. That sounds fantastic. So I noticed you were also in the military. Were you in the military when you were successful with La Bouche?
Well, funny. I've got lots of little stories here. I actually was on active duty station over in Germany when I met Melanie. And we started singing with this cover band called Groovin' Affairs. And then subsequently got this production deal with Frank Farian and Far Music. And then I started touring, you know, while I was still on active duty, you know, just going to Greece, like on the weekends, you know, Friday, Saturday, come back, go to work. And it got to be a little bit too much for me. So, you know, I had to make a decision if I was going to stay in the military or get out. And, you know, getting out, doing this music thing, there was no guarantees. You know, I had child support, car payment, credit cards, you know, you name it, you know. So I just kind of wrote a list of the pros and the cons. And I just stepped out on faith, and, you know, the rest is history. But the whole military thing, you know, I'm still greatly affiliated with them. You know, Melanie and I did a USO tour over in the Middle East. I'm actually in the Air National Guard in Fort Worth, Texas, with the Air Force Band of the Gulf Coast. So I do that once a month and 2 weeks out of the year. And I'll be actually retiring in about 8 months from that.
Oh, wow.
So, you know, big, big, big supporters of the military.
Well, we were so excited to have you today, and we think you're absolutely amazing. And whenever you come up with your new project, we will definitely play the video on Gay Life TV.
Okay.
And, yeah, we'll definitely show it.
Pull up
we'll show it 24 times a day.
Yep. Well, you can actually pull up the one that DJ Blaine Soleil and DJ Eric did for me called Pump It.
Oh, yeah. We were actually just watching that. You looked like you were having a lot of fun in that.
I was. The only thing I didn't like about the video, I was a little heavier. I was on my winter weight during that period. So.
Oh, everyone gets that winter weight. You look amazing right now, and that's all that matters. So, well, thank you for having us, and we thank you for having you. if that makes any sense.
Did you have
Sorry, my brain works in mysterious ways. But it was lovely chatting with you.
Thank you, guys.
And we hope you have a fantastic evening.
Thank you. Likewise.
All right. Enjoy your evening.
Thanks.
Bye. Okay, everyone. That was Lane McCray. He's with the successful Europop dance group, which is called La Bouche. La Bouche. If you guys can guess what La Bouche means, I will give you $100. La Bouche is a French word for the mouth. If you guys guessed that before, then very good work. I just learned that. So we also are interviewing